ongoing projects within the engineering department of the Federal University located at the Ikole Ekiti in Ekiti State was like a fun fair. The dignitaries present at the commissioning ceremony includes the Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Isaac Asuzu, Acting Registrar of the University, Mr. Daniel Adeyemo, and the representative of the President of the Highest Engineering Regulatory Body in Nigeria, CUREN, Engineer Professor J.O. Olajide. Other dignitaries present include His Royal Highness Obasa Oluwole Ademolaju Adugbole III, the Oloye of Oye Kingdom, the representative of the Nigerian Society of Engineers in the person of Engineer Ajanaku, among others.
As you are aware, the Federal University of Oye Ekiti is one of the 9 universities established in February 2011 by the government of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. It is however the only university amongst 9 offering engineering degree programs. The Faculty of Engineering is presently running the following programs. One is the Bachelor of Engineering in Agriculture, Rural and Bioresource Engineering, Bachelor's of Engineering in Civil Engineering, Bachelor's of Engineering in Computer Engineering, Bachelor's of Engineering in Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Bachelor's of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering, and which very soon will be split into two, the Bachelor's of Engineering in Mechatronics Engineering, and Bachelor's of Engineering in Metallurgical and Materials Engineering. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, on October 23, 2013, the university mounted an infrastructure development drive and fundraising dinner in Transcorp Hilton Hotel, Abuja. The program was organized to raise funds and equipment for the Faculty of Engineering Laboratories and Workshop. The occasion keynote address was delivered by the Honorable Minister of Power, Professor Engineer Chinedu Nwuneme-Uduaghan, who was chaired by the current President, Engineer Kashim Abdul Ali, FNSC, MNI, and graced by the then President, Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Mustafa Balarabe Shehu, and eminent engineers from all over the Federation.
The Vice Chancellor, while welcoming the delegates to the event, stated that the Federal University Oye Ekiti is one of the 9 universities established in February 2011 by the federal government, and it's, however, the only university amongst the 9 offering engineering degree programs, among others.
Society of Engineers made initial pledge of 4.2 million naira for the complete metrology laboratory, and he redeemed the pledge within 24 hours. By personally handing over the check to the Vice Chancellor, he later made a further donation of 655,000 naira for
the Vice Chancellor, Professor Isaac Asuzu, was full of praise for the urgent response by Engineer Otis Ayenji for making good his pledge, which he made in October 2013 during the University Infrastructure Fundraising Dinner held at Transcorp Hilton Hotel, Abuja.
What is striking about the obligations was that he gave us the much needed hope and energy to pursue the establishment of the Faculty of Engineering, the daunting financial requirements notwithstanding. I am glad to inform you that in July 2014, all the 7 programs of the Faculty of Engineering have received pre-accreditation by the Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria. In August this year, the faculty programs also were going to NUC accreditation exercise.
He thanks Engineer Otis Ayenji for his encouragement and contribution during the project execution period and accreditation of the engineering department by the Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria, CUREN. Further, he highlighted on the need for metrology studies, which he defined simply as study of measurements.
I thank God for the grace to be part of this historical event in the science, engineering, technology landscape in Nigeria.
Definitely.
It is certainly also a landmark in West Africa and possibly also in Africa. What we are witnessing today. I, as a person, got interested in metrology when my company, Otis Engineering, had to prepare and present a course on crude oil and petroleum products measurement in the 1990s. Before then, we also had been presenting some technical courses like biotechnology, like corrosion engineering, gas turbine technology, pipeline operation and maintenance, cost engineering, engineering inspection, which also relates to metrology somehow, and many others. But one must confess that in preparing this course of measurements of crude oil and petroleum products, I was totally blown away by the sheer esoteric and personal nature of the professionalism involved. Since then, I come to full attention anytime and anywhere the issue of metrology or measurement.
Indeed, it is not surprising that the Vice Chancellor said naming the metrology laboratory after Engineer Otis Ayenji was a decision of the school council, and the gesture is to appreciate Engineer Otis and also to encourage all other well-meaning Nigerians to assist Nigerian university system, mostly in the area of infrastructure provision in the campuses across the country. In his response, Engineer Otis Ayenji, Deputy President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, NSC, and Chairman OT Otis Engineering Limited, thanked the Vice Chancellor, Professor Asuzu, and the entire Council of the University for the honor bestowed on him. He went further to state what caught his attention to meteorology.
From that time also, my interest began to focus on the words of God in the scriptures of measurements. And I took special interest in what was said in Leviticus chapter 19, verses 35 to 36. You shall do no wrong in judgment, in measurement of weight or capacity. You shall have just balances, just weights, a just effort, and a just heave. And we might also recall similar statutes that we'll find in Deuteronomy chapter 25 verse 13 to 16, Ezekiel chapter 45 verse 9 to 10, Amos chapter 8 verse 4 to 6, Hosea chapter 12 verses 7 to 8, Micah chapter 6 verse 10 to 14, Proverbs chapter 20, chapter 11, chapter 16, chapter 20, and chapter 22. And I really commend this for us to go and take a look at what was said about measurement, what God said about measurement. A few years ago, I came across a book titled Cargo Quantity Measurements in the Petroleum Industry by Okotiemu Foreman David, the petroleum and natural gas engineer. I was so impressed by the contents of the book that rather than keep it in our office library, where we have over 10,000 volumes. Anyway, I put it together with my Bible and divine office on my bedside cabinet. And from time to time, I take a bite, a little each time to chew. Such was my mindset and attitude to measurement when in the afternoon of October 23rd, 2013, the president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, then Engineer Mustafa B. Shehu, FNSC, called and asked that I accompany him to a function at the Transcom meeting that evening. When I realized that it was a fundraising event, I complained to President Shehu that I was not invited to the event and that in the least I was going to feel awkward there. But the president of NSC brushed aside those concerns and insisted that I accompany him to the function. I am West and accompanied President Shehu to 4 years infrastructure development drive and fundraising dinner at the Transcom later. On getting there, we were welcomed by the Vice Chancellor, Professor Isaac U. Asuzu, FCVSN, and my classmate, Professor Christian Bodo, FNSC, who I later realized was the Dean Faculty of Engineering.
Engineer Otis, who later went memory lane, reminding the listeners that God the Creator also have a great interest in measurements.
By the time he further stated that to merely depend, as we are used to saying in Nigeria, on God's grace without preparation would amount to career suicide. But while God's grace abounds, a step in the right direction will trigger it. I started seeing university leadership as soulmates.
On how he came about the donation, he told the audience thus.
Support the meteorology laboratory project. As fate would have it, the next day I was on board the overland flight to Akure from Abuja. A gentleman made his way past me to his seat somewhere behind mine. Some moments later, this gentleman came and stopped by me, thanking me for the support I had pledged for the university. I quickly realized that was the Vice Chancellor.
The event, which came to a grand finale with the cutting of the tape to unveil the facilities installed in the Engineer Otis Anyeji Meteorology Laboratory, first of its kind in Nigeria University.
Well, this means a great deal, you know, to me, especially in terms of my philanthropic activities towards the development of education and the development of the human being in Nigeria. And if you listen to my speech, you will notice that this really wouldn't have been as such, because the event that brought about this gesture from me, we are programmed, and I would say to my exclusion, I wasn't invited to the event. I didn't know, but the president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers then, Engineer Mustafa Balarebe Shehu, fellow Nigerian Society of Engineers, he called me up at about maybe 3 o'clock in the afternoon and said I have to come with him to go for a function taking place at the Hilton about 8 o'clock in the evening. And I tried to find out what for, and realized that it was a kind of fundraising. And I hesitated, you know, but I wasn't invited. So me going there would be a bit of an inconvenience. But he persuaded me to come on, and we went, and I'm glad that I did. And it was when I was there that I saw they were trying to promote courses for development of the Faculty of Engineering in this university. It was also at that occasion I learned that the Dean of Engineering in the university is my classmate in the university, and that they had very many beautiful programs they wanted to do. But the one that fascinated me most was the one on metrology, because I had been even trying to found an institute for metrology engineers in the Nigerian Society of Engineers. So when I saw that they were trying to do something on metallurgy, I was really swept away. And I just immediately decided that, yes, I was going to support that particular program for the development of this metrology laboratory. And, I mean, that was done just for the love of that specialization, not for anything else. I mean, they didn't say they were going to name anything after anybody. They just were appealing for people to help. And in good conscience, I was persuaded to help. Mm. Well, my view is that certainly we are not doing the much we ought to do, both the government and the private citizens. We are not doing enough. And we can do better. And we just have to do better, because that is the foundation of the entire society. If Nigeria is going to be better, it is not about us. It is not about those in our age bracket. It is not about those in our status. It is really about those who are coming up. It is about those being born and those that are yet to be born, and the facilities we are making available for their education, for their skills acquisition, and for their engagement. So that is really very important, very foundational, that we can once again, as had been the case, be able to say that, hey, our secondary schools are just like what it is in London or in New York or anywhere. And that was so before. I mean, take Christ the King College, you heard about King's College in Lagos, you heard about the DMGS in Onitsha, you heard about Hope Wardell, and so on and so forth. And what did the matching grant mean? It meant the government and the individual or voluntary agency or who a community that was setting up the institution to sit down with the government and work out how much it costs for operating costs to train one student. And the government would pay a percentage of that, up to 50% when you have accomplished everything that has been specified in the plan. And it was by doing that that the Eastern region now got more secondary schools than the West. It was a form of PPP at that time, or privatization, call it. That's what was used. We should go back to it. The government shouldn't look at somebody who is setting up a primary school and then leave the person to the limits of his resources. The government should look into that also and make contributions, because ordinarily the government is responsible for education. But we all realize they cannot do it alone. But when it sees those who are genuinely, you know, interested in assisting to get that worked out, the government must also make funding available to them to some limit. So that is what I think about our education, and that applies to primary, secondary, tertiary education. What my achievement, because I worked on the NIPP project as the joint project director of the Otis Lamia joint venture, the design and management consultant on the entire NIPP phase one, which is a program of 10 power stations. 8 of them have been completed now. 110 transmission lines and substations. The vast majority of them are completed. And on Monday, 3 days ago, the 330, 132, 33 kV substation in Abuja was commissioned. Tomorrow, we're going to commission the biggest substation in the transmission system, the transmission network in Okero. And it's now 2x300 MVA transformers and another 2x60 MVA that helps also deliver power at the lower level of 33 kVA. And we have almost 10 lines on 33 kV taking off from that substation and supplying parts of Lagos already. That substation is going to commission tomorrow. So we are leaving here to go to Lagos for that, as they have done in phase one. They have done fairly well in payments. There are those who are not being paid for one thing or the other, but these are procurement problems, you know? But generally, if all procurement issues are resolved and the work accomplished, certified, the payments under phase one have been admirable. And we advise the government to continue like that on phase two. Then the next thing is to look at the quality of contractors, consultants. The track record from phase one is a good starting point. Those who have created problems in phase one certainly have to be well, but I mean, they have to beware. There's a kind of caveat emptor about such a category of people. If the government desires, then they can engage us more to talk about that. And when that is done, you will see that sustainability is really going to bring itself about with that. And I believe that when all these basic measures are put in place and good contractors are selected, payments are done in time, much of the bulk materials are locally made, I think we can do phase two within schedule, within the right quality, and even below the budget. But that's just the tip of the iceberg. I think that we can even do phase three, phase four, phase five, and continue like that, because we would have built a local capacity for repeating that from the manufacturing end of the value chain down to the construction and the installation. Well, I mean, security is one of the issues. The one they must have been complaining and you heard about is perhaps that somebody vandalized the existing gas line and so disrupted supplies. But there are also the issues of non-availability of that capacity, and that has to do with perhaps those who are in a position to make such investments not being willing to make the investment because certain commercial considerations, in fact, the commercial infrastructure is not quite in place. That the government has to handle and handle with dispatch. So that, I mean, we take that as a settled issue, and we know if the security is provided, gas will flow. Thank you. Well, I mean, the growth of engineering in Nigeria, as I said, has been affected by the manner of the regulation. And we are already working on that from both the Nigerian Society of Engineers and from CORIN. And I'm happy that the leadership in both sides are quite understanding and already taking proactive measures that are beginning to address those structural defects in the manner of regulating, because we want to go from parastatal regulation to chartered regulatory status. And we are working on that, and by the grace of God, we'll continue to work on that.